Seattle's contribution to popular music is undisputed. You know the names, from Hendrix to Heart, Pearl Jam, Macklemore, and many, many more in between. In this series, we're going to examine Seattle's music community, in depth with unique performances, with interviews, and much, much more. We're also going to find out what makes Seattle, Seattle, and what makes this city on the shores of the Puget Sound one of the best places on the planet for music. Welcome to Sounds by the Sound.
Let's rock and roll.
Welcome to another episode of Sounds by the Sound. We are outside the old home of Seattle community radio station KEXP, which has been around for decades. Now, it's been tried and true here in Seattle for a long time. Something funny happened though about 15 years ago when KEXP started broadcasting online. Their reputation of impeccable music discovery, championing new artists and live performances started to spread globally, and people around the world started tuning in to this Seattle radio station. It's been the launching point for so many great artists over the years. Macklemore and Ryan Lewis probably wouldn't be where they are today if it weren't for KEXP. The same could be said for bands like Nirvana and numerous others from the Pacific Northwest. Just recently, KEXP got a home befit of now their global status over in the Seattle Center, a place that's so much more than just a radio station. It is a community gathering point for all things Seattle music. It is a very, very special place. We're going to talk to the people and the personalities behind KEXP on what makes this radio station so special and why their new space was so necessary. We're also going to talk to some of the artists who have been impacted by KEXP. They've helped out so many bands from the Pacific Northwest, starting with the Cave Singers. Here's a performance right now, Sounds by the Sound. Thank you. brand new home of Seattle radio station KEXP here in the Seattle Center with, without question, one of the best bands in the Northwest over the last decade is the KEXP. Your band, like a lot of Northwest bands, has a great relationship with KEXP. And I was wondering if you could talk about why a radio station like this is important for a band like yours.
We started with KEXP really early on. They're really supportive of us, like right from the get-go, inviting us to play like barbecues that they have almost 10 years ago.
Mm-hmm. I mean, they were the first ones to play us. I mean, you could just see like your shows start getting bigger and people start like, oh, I heard this song on the radio.
Sure.
And even with the new record, immediately they were playing it. It was awesome, mm-hmm. You know, and they played it like every day.
Is this unique to Seattle, at least as far as the success of it is concerned?
I think as far as what I've seen is it is unique to Seattle. This is where there were enough people to make it happen. I mean, it's incredible.
It's definitely a credit to the people that run KEXP and the music community to both support this and the artists. It's a nice symbiotic, is that the right word? It's a nice relationship.
Yeah, I think symbiotic.
Big words. I'm sure I used that word wrong. Let's talk about your music.
All right.
Let's talk about Banshee. It's your fifth full-length record. There's a little bit of a break between the last record and this record. How did that break affect this record?
We just kind of had more time, and so we felt a little bit more relaxed and kind of organically let the record present itself when it wanted to, mm-hmm. instead of kind of trying to force it, I guess.
There was something said about the record, and correct me if I'm wrong, instead of trying to capture the live sound, it was more trying to capture the emotion that the band plays when it's live on this album.
Yeah.
Was that successful?
I think so.
Okay, good.
We actually recorded it live.
Yeah. Did you?
Yeah. There's hardly any overdubs. You know, we're all in a room. The vocals are live. Just to have that, you know?
It's really like kind of a magical quest to try to figure out how to make a record sound live. Mm-hmm. Maybe you can't do it. Every time you try to accomplish that and emulate it in a way.
You guys have been a part of the Seattle music community, obviously, for a long time. What's special and unique about this town and that world?
I mean, it's a huge music scene. It's a relatively small city, and we have more venues and more bands than most of the big cities. It's such a music town, and it seems like it always has been.
You guys are going out on the road. You guys tour a lot.
We have another tour coming up in a couple of weeks,
okay.
And then we're also playing Capitol Hill Block Party, which is a big festival here in Seattle.
Yeah. Fellas, thanks for being here.
Yeah.
Thanks for talking with us.
Of course.
And really thank you for playing.
Yeah,
That's super special for us, and we're stoked on it.
Yeah.
Watch out for the dog.
Oh, yeah, we'll be careful.
And here we go. Banshee is the name of the latest Cave Singers record. It is out now. You're watching Sounds by the Sound.
Next up, we'll hear from one of the best, most exciting young bands in the Pacific Northwest, a band that's being championed by KEXP. We'll hear about what inspires them collectively, about their love for Seattle, each other, and why this radio station is so important to them. Here they are, it's Beat Connection.
To get to know you, Rosaline, real life woman of my dreams. I wanna get to know you, Rosaline, real life woman of my dreams. Lately, I can see so clearly, I feel good. Whenever you are near me, I think that you feel the same way too. So what I wanna do, I wanna get to know you, girl, you, Rosaline, real life woman of my dreams. I wanna get to know you, girl, you, Rosaline, real life woman of my dreams. So you got to tell me what you wanna do in the end.
It's up to you, yeah, yeah, to tell me what you wanna do. And then it's up to you, yeah, yeah, to tell me what you wanna do. And then it's up to you. Now I wanna get to know you, girl, you, Rosalind, Rosalind. Real life, a woman of my day. Real life woman of my dreams. I wanna get to know you, know you.
Yo, what's up? It's Beat Connection. We're here at KEXP's new home. Beat Connection is just about like doing songs together and really trusting one another on a collaborative level, trying to take all of our disparate influences and bring them together to create something that represents a very narrow common ground that we all share. And that's important to us. I think that's where we create the stuff that we're the most proud of collectively. And it's a process, no doubt, but it's a super rewarding process to create these songs. Like, when we talk about music, it's not always about like, oh, we should do a song like that. It's like, we should do a song that feels the way this scene in a movie feels, or something like that. Or like the way some goofy social interaction made you feel, or a painting or something like that. So we think about music and art and visual media and all that stuff intersecting and coming together. That's the MO in the van, is just talking about real life and putting something cool to it at all times. Every time we do a show in Seattle, we take a lot of care to make it different than the last one. Probably like to a fault, just spending too much time on like, oh, what if we did the song this way when it was fine the first way. So each time we do it, it's really exciting to play to a hometown crowd, to play to our friends, our family, and stuff like that. So that's always super exciting.
How could I ever be the one to let you go? You gotta let me know. Because ooh, they get so good.
We're most inspired by like the kind of breaking the mold and like taking ownership of your own thing ethos that exists in the Northwest the most, as opposed to like one specific genre. We're kind of atypical in our influences. Like, it's not lost upon us that we live in a beautiful place here in the Northwest in Seattle. I didn't have an older sibling serving me Northwest indie rock. I had the internet serving me like 128 kilobyte MP3s of dancehall and French touch music and New York indie and stuff from Southern California. And so just trying to like scoop it all in and take it all at once. And that's another thing that's like pretty present in the programming of the radio station. And like a lot of stuff that's going on in the city is just like bring it all together and make it a community that's, you know, this is not a big town, not a small town either. With the music community, it's really like everyone's in it for each other, which I think is super cool.
One of the coolest things that we found on tour was that all these people came up to us at our show being like, hey, I saw you guys on the KEXP in studio video, and now I'm here because of that video.
Yeah.
And so to have that reach for however long KEXP's been around, and for now to kind of like kick it up a notch and bring more people and make sure everyone's more involved is like huge, so.
Welcome back to Sounds by the Sound. Right now we're gonna take a tour of KEXP's immaculate new facilities over at the Seattle Center. You're watching Sounds by the Sound.
We are at the beautiful new home of KEXP here in the Seattle Center, and we are here with Charlize, who has been hosting their local show, Audio Oasis, for quite some time. Now, is there a specific name for this place?
We call it the public gathering space.
Okay,
so
great.
It's open to the public. Uh-huh. Anyone can come through and sit and hang out.
Brand new home. Thank you to my 2,000 new friends here at the Seattle Center.
This station doesn't exist anywhere but Seattle. It couldn't. There's no way. There's no community, no city that would support a station like it has here. You have billionaires and kids giving what they can, allowance to major grants. And then you have this creative community of musicians and the music business that we support and they support us. And then the individual giving and spirit of our city is so strong. People want to give, they want to support something they believe in here. And I just don't see that in other cities.
Radio is not seen, it's heard.
Yeah, absolutely.
And
yeah.
I think we are changing that. So being able to celebrate local music or just music in general, you can come here and you can totally drown yourself in music.
It's amazing to see people here listening to music, doing their thing, people doing coffee shops, but talking to each other and having KEXP be the thing that brought them together. It's really the public space and the gathering space and the live and studio space that I think I've been most blown away by. We're in the center of town, the Seattle Center. KEXP could make this area so vital and culturally important is a big deal to us here at KEXP, and to me in particular.
We are at the brand new home of KEXP with one of their DJs. Hell of a guy is Troy Nelson. How are you, sir?
All right, how are you?
What are you looking most forward to?
Having the space for the live bands. Uh-huh. Because before, bands didn't have any room to explore. Mm-hmm. But in this room, there's mm-hmm. more room to explore and be creative.
Well, this is so much more than just a radio station now at this point. You have the gathering space, you have the studio, you have the live studio, you have a venue, you have a whole video production area to get that sort of thing on video. It is now much more, again,
it's a multimedia, you know.
Conglomerate,
juggernaut.
Exactly.
I mean, this space back here, we have 400, 500 bands a year. They can play back there now instead of a small closet. You know, our engineer can actually use a board that is the right board to be using. As a DJ, to be able to use the different technologies that are available to me. And then on top of that, to be able to DJ and see the public. That is a new thing.
All right, what's the best way to go? You want to head left?
Let's go into the library.
Okay, cool.
This is a very special place.
Yeah.
Our library is so insane and one of the best you will find anywhere. Tens of thousands of records, hundreds of thousands of CDs.
So this is The Queen Is Dead, which everyone loves.
Of course, yeah. But there's like, it looks like someone has written notes on there. What do those notes mean?
Well, these are reviews.
Oh, cool.
And they're all reviewed. They're all have comments on them. They go back, our station's 40 years old, so it goes back 40 years and then beyond with music that came out before that. Still to this day, I discover things in there that I haven't found before. I mean, if you're a music geek at all, you can imagine, it's awesome.
So this is the green room.
Yes.
What was the purpose here? What was the idea behind making this room this way?
To better be able to serve our artists that are coming through, our touring artists.
We want to make sure you come in here and get treated well. I don't care if you're a small local band with just a demo out or you're the Flaming Lips. When you come in here, you're going to be treated the same. And in this new home, we've expanded that. So I think more bands are going to want to come here simply because of the washer and dryer probably in the green room and the shower.
I think it's really important that KEXP provides this kind of hospitality mm-hmm. to our artists, and that it also helps them put on the best performance that they can.
It shows our commitment and our respect for their art. I'm pretty proud of bands. We're the first to play bands like Death Cab for Cutie that are local to, you know, name 50 other indie bands. You know, the most recent is the Lumineers. I get credit for that one a lot. There's just so many that some blow up and some don't. You know, you can take credit for the big ones and that's cool. Like Macklemore and Ryan Lewis is the easiest one on earth. Like when they were done with the heist, he called me. He's like, John, you know, we just finished. We've been up for 48 hours. Can we come up to the show and debut it? And I said, yeah, come on down. So they showed up on the show at like 8 a.m. and we debuted the heist. And then they debuted the songs live on Kevin's show. And you had that happen all the time. We didn't know it'd be that big. We just knew it was so good and so local that we needed to support it. So there's a very long list, but those are a couple of good ones.
Thanks so much to Beat Connection and the Cave Singers for their performances on our episode today. And special thanks KEXP for letting us take over their space and making this all happen. Now, I'm going to leave you with another performance from Beat Connection. We'll be right back.
siren face. How could I ever be the one to let you go? You got to let me know. What if I woke up on a different day, stepping at a different pace? How could I ever be the one to let you go? You got to let me know.
How to make a record sound live. Mm-hmm. Maybe you can't do it. Every time you try to accomplish that and emulate it in a way.
You guys have been a part of the Seattle music community, obviously, for a long time. Yeah. What's special and unique about this town and that world?
I mean, it's a huge music scene. It's a relatively small city, and we have more venues and more bands than most of the big cities. It's such a music town,
yeah.
And it seems like it always has been.
You guys are going out on the road. You guys tour a lot.
We have another tour coming up in a couple of weeks,
okay.
And then we're also playing Capitol Hill Block Party, which is a big festival here in Seattle.
Yeah. Fellas, thanks for being here.
Yeah.
Thanks for talking with us.
Of course.
And really thank you for playing.
Yeah, yeah.
That's super special for us, and we're stoked on it.
Yeah.
Watch out for the dog.
Oh, yeah, we'll be careful.
And there we go. Banshee is the name of the latest Cave Singers record. It is out now. You're watching Sounds by the Sound.
Next up, we'll hear from one of the best, most exciting young bands in the Pacific Northwest, a band that's being championed by KEXP. We'll hear about what inspires them collectively, about their love for Seattle, each other, and why this radio station is so important to them. Here they are. It's Beat Connection.
Wanna get to know you, know you, Rosaline, Rosaline, real life woman of my dreams. I wanna get to know you, know you, Rosaline, Rosaline, real life woman of my dreams. Lately I can see so clearly, I feel good. Whenever you are near me, I think that you feel the same way too. So what I wanna do, oh, I wanna get to know you, girl, you, Rosaline, Rosaline, real life woman of my dreams. I wanna get to know you, girl, you, Rosaline, Rosaline, real life woman of my dreams. So you got to tell me what you wanna do in the end. It's
listen to you. Yeah, yeah, to tell me what you wanna do. In the end, listen to you. Yeah, yeah, to tell me what you wanna do. In the end, it's up to you. I wanna get to know you, from you, Rosaline, Rosaline, real life woman of my dreams. I wanna get to know you, from you, Rosaline, Rosaline, real life woman of my dreams. I wanna get to know you,
Yo, what's up? It's Beat Connection. We're here at KEXP's new home. Beat Connection is just about like doing songs together and really trusting one another on a collaborative level, trying to take all of our disparate influences and bring them together to create something that represents a very narrow common ground that we all share. And that's important to us. I think that's where we create the stuff that we're the most proud of collectively. And it's a process, no doubt, but it's a super rewarding process to create these songs. Like, when we talk about music, it's not always about like, oh, we should do a song like that. It's like, we should do a song that feels the way this scene in a movie feels, or something like that. Or like the way some goofy social interaction made you feel, or a painting or something like that. So we think about music and art and visual media and all that stuff intersecting and coming together. That's the MO in the van, is just talking about real life and putting something cool to it at all times. Every time we do a show in Seattle, we take a lot of care to make it different than the last one. Probably like to a fault, just spending too much time on like, oh, what if we did the song this way when it was fine the first way. So each time we do it, it's really exciting to play to a hometown crowd, to play to our friends, our family, and stuff like that. So that's always super exciting.
How could I ever be the one to let you go? You gotta let me know. Because you make it so good.
We're most inspired by like the kind of breaking the mold and like taking ownership of your own thing ethos that exists in the Northwest the most, as opposed to like one specific genre. We're kind of atypical in our influences. Like, it's not lost upon us that we live in a beautiful place here in the Northwest in Seattle. I didn't have an older sibling serving me Northwest indie rock. I had the internet serving me like 128 kilobyte MP3s of dance hall and French touch music and New York indie and stuff from Southern California. And so just trying to like scoop it all in and take it all at once. And that's another thing that's like pretty present in the programming of the radio station. And like a lot of stuff that's going on in the city is just like bring it all together and make it a community that's, you know, this is not a big town, not a small town either. With the music community, it's really like everyone's in it for each other, which I think is super cool.
One of the coolest things that we found on tour was that all these people came up to us at our show being like, hey, I saw you guys on the KEXP in studio video, and now I'm here because of that video.
Yeah.
And so to have that reach for however long KEXP's been around, and for now to kind of like kick it up a notch and bring more people and make sure everyone.
This holy roller, she's my southern belle, keeps me down in hell, but we're happy. How does she hold me?
here at the brand new home of Seattle radio station KEXP here in the Seattle Center with, without question, one of the best bands in the Northwest over the last decade is the KEXP. Your band, like a lot of Northwest bands, has a great relationship with KEXP. And I was wondering if you could talk about why a radio station like this is important for a band like yours.
We started with KEXP really early on. They're really supportive of us, like right from the get-go, inviting us to play like barbecues that they have almost 10 years ago.
Mm-hmm. I mean, they were the first ones to play us. I mean, you could just see like your shows start getting bigger and people start like, oh, I heard this song on the radio. Sure. And even with the new record, immediately they were playing it. It was awesome. Mm-hmm. You know, they played it like every day.
Is this unique to Seattle, at least as far as the success of it is concerned?
I think as far as what I've seen is it is unique to Seattle. This is where the people, there were enough people to make it happen. I mean, it's incredible.
It's definitely a credit to the people that run KEXP and the music community to both support this and the artists.
It's a nice symbiotic, is that the right word? It's a nice relationship.
I think symbiotic.
You're a big word. I'm sure I used that word wrong. Let's talk about your music.
All right.
Let's talk about Banshee.
It's your fifth full-length record. There's a little bit of a break between the last record and this record. How did that break affect this record?
We just kind of had more time, and so we felt a little bit more relaxed and kind of organically let the record present itself when it wanted to, mm-hmm. instead of kind of trying to force it, I guess.
There was something said about the record, and correct me if I'm wrong, instead of trying to capture the live sound, it was more trying to capture the emotion that the band plays when it's live on this album.
Yeah.
Was that successful?
I think so.
Okay, good.
We actually recorded it live.
Yeah. Did you?
Yeah. There's hardly any overdubs. You know, we were all in a room. The vocals are live. Just to have that, you know?
It's really like kind of a magical quest to try to...
Seattle's contribution to popular music is undisputed. You know the names, from Hendrix to Heart, Pearl Jam, Macklemore, and many, many more in between. In this series, we're going to examine Seattle's music community in depth with unique performances, with interviews, and much, much more. We're also going to find out what makes Seattle, Seattle, and what makes this city on the shores of the Puget Sound one of the best places on the planet for music. Welcome to Sounds by the Sound.
Let's rock and roll.
Welcome to another episode of Sounds by the Sound. We are outside the old home of Seattle community radio station KEXP, which has been around for decades. Now, it's been tried and true here in Seattle for a long time. Something funny happened though about 15 years ago when KEXP started broadcasting online. Their reputation of impeccable music discovery, championing new artists and live performances started to spread globally, and people around the world started tuning in to this Seattle radio station. It's been the launching point for so many great artists over the years. Macklemore and Ryan Lewis probably wouldn't be where they are today if it weren't for KEXP. The same could be said for bands like Nirvana and numerous others from the Pacific Northwest. Just recently, KEXP got a home befit of now their global status over in the Seattle Center, a place that's so much more than just a radio station. It is a community gathering point for all things Seattle music. It is a very, very special place. We're going to talk to the people and the personalities behind KEXP on what makes this radio station so special and why their new space was so necessary. We're also going to talk to some of the artists who have been impacted by KEXP. They've helped out so many bands from the Pacific Northwest, starting with the Cave Singers. Here's a performance right now, Sounds by the Sound. Thank you.
myself. Thunder, yeah, lightning, but I got shelter, what I need.
Once more involved is like huge, so.
Welcome back to Sounds by the Sound. Right now we're gonna take a tour of KEXP's immaculate new facilities over at the Seattle Center. You're watching Sounds by the Sound.
We are at the beautiful new home of KEXP here in the Seattle Center, and we're here with Charlize, who has been hosting their local show, Audio Oasis, for quite some time. Now, is there a specific name for this place?
We call it the public gathering space.
Okay,
so
great.
It's open to the public. Uh-huh. Anyone can come through and sit and hang out.
Brand new home. Thank you to my 2,000 new friends here at the Seattle Center.
This station doesn't exist anywhere but Seattle. It couldn't. There's no way. There's no community, no city that would support a station like it has here. You have billionaires and kids giving what they can, allowance to major grants. And then you have this creative community of musicians and the music business that we support and they support us. And then the individual giving and spirit of our city is so strong. People want to give, they want to support something they believe in here, and I just don't see that in other cities.
Radio is not seen, it's heard.
Yeah, absolutely.
And
yeah.
I think we are changing that. So being able to celebrate local music or just music in general, you can come here and you can totally drown yourself in music.
It's amazing to see people here listening to music, doing their thing, people doing coffee shops, but talking to each other and having KEXP be the thing that brought them together. It's really the public space and the gathering space and the live and studio space that I think I've been most blown away by. We're in the center of town, the Seattle Center. KEXP could make this area so vital and culturally important is a big deal to us here at KEXP, and to me in particular.
We are at the brand new home of KEXP with one of their DJs. Hell of a guy is Troy Nelson. How are you, sir?
All right, how are you?
What are you looking most forward to?
Having the space for the live bands. Uh-huh. Because before, bands didn't have any room to explore. Mm-hmm. But in this room, there's mm-hmm. more room to explore and be creative.
Well, this is so much more than just a radio station now at this point. You have,
yeah.
you have the gathering space, you have the studio, you have the live studio, you have a venue, mm-hmm. you have a whole video production area to
yeah.
get that sort of thing on video. It is now much more, again.
It's a multimedia, yeah. you know.
Conglomerate.
Is that juggernaut.
Right yeah, exactly.
I mean, this space back here, we have 400, 500 bands a year. They can play back there now instead of a small closet. You know, our engineer can actually use a board that is the right board to be using. As a DJ, to be able to use the different technologies that are available to me. And then on top of that, to be able to DJ and see the public. That is a new thing.
All right, what's the best way to go? You want to head left?
Let's go into the library.
Okay, cool.
This is a very special place.
Yeah.
Our library is so insane and one of the best you will find anywhere. Tens of thousands of records, hundreds of thousands of CDs.
So this is The Queen is Dead, which everyone loves.
Of course, yeah, yeah, but there's like, it looks like someone has written notes on there. What do those notes mean?
Well, these are reviews.
Oh, cool.
And they're all reviewed. They're all have comments on them. They go back, our station's 40 years old, so it goes back 40 years and then beyond with music that came out before that.